Hello and welcome to 84 TV Radio Weekly Review of top stories reaching you from Abuja, the Nigerian capital. I am Anthonyetta Kalunta. Within the week, we brought you a developing report about the Nigerian Inspector General Muhammad Adamu giving orders that former officers of the now defunct Special Anti-Robbery Squad SARS be barred from joining the newly created Special Weapons and Tactics SWAT unit of the Nigerian Police. It will be recalled that the IG, in response to the End SARS protest, dissolved the police unit and set up a new police outfit to take over. The new outfit, known as Special Weapons and Tactics Team SWAT, will fill the gaps arising from the dissolution of SARS. Adamu also made public the mandate of the newly formed SWAT team, which includes response to robbery attacks, rescue operations, and special operations involving high-profile criminals. The police explained that the response was the first time a decisive action was taken to dissolve the unit. An investigative team will be constituted to involve civil liberty societies, assuring that justice will prevail.
Changes came up and still we have challenges. So this is the first time that a decisive decision was taken to dissolve the unit. We've never done it before, and we've never said it before. It was always reform, reform, reform. And why are we doing this? We are doing this because police is to serve the public, to serve the people. So if the people you are serving are saying that one of your services is not servicing us well, then we need to listen to what the public are saying and then adjust.
Also within the weekend review, the Minister of State for Education, Emeka Nwajuba, and executive members of the Academic Staff Union of Polytechnics, ASUP, met in Abuja in an effort to avert the union's planned nationwide strike. The ASUP delegation was led by its president, Anderson Ezeibe, who appealed to the minister to intervene in some lingering issues. Ezeibe told the minister that the relevant issues predated COVID-19.
We have states where our members are out for 21 months. We have states where our members were not paid all through the period of the lockdown. And yet we are talking about national standards, and we wonder the kind of standard that will be kept in such institutions where our members are owed salaries to this extent. Now, the key issue, the other issue is the issue of the IPPIS, which our members enrolled into in November 2019 with a whole lot of promises made to us. As we speak, we are still having cases of omissions of our members from the payroll. We still have the issue of non-remittance of National Housing Fund deductions. We have non-remittance and inconsistencies in deductions and remittances of our union checkup dues. And also the fact that that office unilaterally closed the window for corrections with respect to members' data.
Nwajuba, in his response, said that the ministry would give a detailed response in 1 week after scrutiny of the demands made.
We're going to take these 10 items that you have listed here, and we're going to carefully ask the ministry to reply you. And we will agree that that is the proper response. We are on the verge of having our visitation panels to your schools, which will then inform us a bit more as to actions that need to be taken. So we will not take your items seriatim at the moment and start discussing them as if we have positions that are fixed on them. But we've taken them, and we assure you that in the next 1 week, at the very minimum, we'll be able to reply you with a detail and step-by-step processes around each of the items that you have raised.
You may recall that ASUP had issued a 15-day ultimatum to the federal government to meet demands dating several years back. Until recently, adolescents in many cultures are not given adequate information bordering on sexual matters. However, with the rise in vices like rape and gender-based violence, the importance of sex is even more in focus. This has generated advocacy for teaching of sex education in schools. 84 TV Radio within the week spoke with Nigerians on the matter.
According to the UNICEF, only 3 in 5 girls aged 5 to 17 are likely to achieve their goal of becoming great in life. The reasons range from social vices covering rape and sexual assault to gender-based violence and child marriage, just to mention a few. However, there is a debate as to whether there is a nexus between sex education and its effectiveness in instilling virtues that could help curb the rise of social vices such as rape, gender violence, sexual assault, and child marriage. A few persons say sex education should be continued and that the knowledge from it shouldn't be taught only in schools.
Talking about sex education, I think it should be taught in schools, like should be continued. You know, it's a gradual process. So in Nigeria today, most of like the way we live and where we come from, I think that we still have a long way to go for it to reach into the rural areas and communities around. So I think from my own perspective, I think it should continue.
Others say more awareness should be created about sex education and that most victims of sexual assault lack such education since it is not being taught enough in schools. They therefore make a case for its continuation.
Yes, I think it should be taught in schools because knowledge is key, knowledge is power. Many of the people that are falling into sexual messes, be it real, be it being any kind of sexual mess, most of them actually not aware. Although several fell into it because of circumstances, but most actually, especially about young ones. I want to believe it's not even taught enough in schools, as a matter of fact. When I was in school, I'm not sure I ever heard any part of our class, whether the former class or informal, talk to our ladies, including ourselves, the guys, on anything like that.
Others of the opinion that sex education shouldn't be taught in schools since parents are in the best position to teach this to their children.
Personally, I don't think it should be taught in schools. I think the parents are in a better position to teach their children about sex education because they understand their children better and their children understand their parents.
Sex education may not have achieved set objective, but according to experts, some variables need to be factored into the general scenario when it comes to sex education. Some of these are information about puberty and reproduction, abstinence, contraception and condoms, relationships, sexual violence prevention, body image, gender identity and sexual orientation. This is further insistence that it should be taught by trained teachers. Olamide Aitalegbe, AD40 Radio, Abuja.
We take a break now. When we return, social justice for women in focus. Please stay with us. Details coming up shortly. Welcome back. You're watching AD4TV Radio Weekly Review. We brought it to you this past week that as schools were set to reopen October 12th, students and parents were gearing up for academic activities after a period of halt due to the COVID-19 pandemic. While some were jubilant over the development, skepticism still trailed the go-back-to-school move for fear of COVID-19. AD4TV Radio asked some Abuja residents if homeschooling was an option for them.
With the long stay away from school, there are mixed reactions in several circles. Amidst this, homeschooling is rearing up as a good idea.
We can't run away from knowledge. Knowledge cannot be thrown away, and every day is important to gain particular knowledge. So learning from home or school training or an education path is very, very important. I think it's a good idea if any parent could undergo that, especially this period.
There are a lot of things happening. A lot of big men are now in e-education and all these things because there are a lot of people that cannot afford, that have never touched system before. So home education is very important. I think it should be an option.
Some people, however, state that the choice lies with parents.
Some parents can do so because they think the COVID-19 is real. But people think it's not real, and they will bring teachers to come and be teaching their children at home, like summer lesson. So they will teach their children at home, but some parents that cannot be able, they will take their children to school.
Given the halt to educational and other activities by the COVID-19 pandemic, clear-cut options to safeguard all involved and ensure education is not disrupted is crucial consideration. Olamide Aitalegbe, AD4TV Radio, Abuja.
A driver's license certifies that a person is eligible to drive within the country. However, with the prevalence of teenagers with driving skills good as any, AG4 TV Radio went to the roads to ascertain if it is a good idea to drop the age for obtaining a driver's license.
Lawful permission to drive on public highways is granted based on a set of conditions, one of which the age requirement sets at 18 years of age and above. Despite this provision, young persons below this age clamor for licenses.
The official age universally agreed is 18 years. When somebody is 18, someone is 18 years, can obtain his driver license. In advanced country, for example, I'll use an American example. If a child is going to be 18 the next day, it's a big celebration, both in the family or within his group. And he can never one day have access to driving license until he clocks 18, and he cannot even climb the stairing until he clocks 18.
It should not be reduced because maturity, I know, also comes with age. So the age of 18, which is also the age of franchise, voting and so on. Some people that are under such age, I think they are not mature enough. And driving is not just about carrying the car on the road. Your mental ability is supposed to be stable as an individual and as an adult before you enter the road as a driver. So you don't need to, there shouldn't be such a law that people under 18 years should be given driving license for any reasons.
Some others say it's a good thing if a teenager knows how to drive, but he shouldn't be on the highway.
If you are a teenager, just because your parent has cars, you can drive any car. It's good you have driving license, but you should not be allowed to drive in the town because those kind people are the ones causing accidents all over.
Some persons, however, say the age criterion should step down to 16.
To me, let them reduce that thing to 16. To 16 years, that's the thing. A 16 years can if you have a good experience, that's the thing, you can drive.
Having driving skills is increasingly seen as a necessity rather than a luxury. Olamide Aitalegbe, AD4 TV Radio, Abuja.
Results of the push for affirmative action of 30% for women, especially in appointive positions, remain marginal in Nigeria. Executive Director, Center for Social Justice, Eze Onyekwere, in a chat with AD4 TV Radio, opines that necessary policies must be in place to achieve social justice for women. Remember, coronavirus is real. Ensure you wash your hands regularly. Use alcohol-based hand sanitizers. Wear your mask besides maintaining social distancing. That's it for our weekly review. You can join the conversation on our website at www.ad4tvradio.com. Please follow us on our social media platforms at AD4TVRadio on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Instagram. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel at AD4TVRadio as well. Many thanks for watching. I am Antonietta Kalunta.